Assalamu alaikum. Dear students, our today's topic is to study about the biofuels. So biofuel is any fuel that is derived from biomass. Biomass is organic material that comes from plants and animals. Alright, so any fuel that is obtained from plant material, algal material or animal waste, that fuel is called as biofuel. As the name suggests, so the fuels that is derived from the living material is called as biofuel, and these biofuels can be solid, gaseous or liquid. However, in a narrow sense, these biofuels refer only to liquid biofuels that are used for transport. Biofuels can be used to replace fossil fuels, and these fossil fuels can also, biofuels can also be used in addition to diesel, petrol or other fossil fuels for transport, transport stationery and other applications. And the energy that is derived from biofuels is called as bioenergy. Overall, bioenergy covers approximately 10% of the total world energy demand. Traditional unprocessed biomass, for example, fuel wood, charcoal and animal dung, you know, represents the main source of energy for a large section of people in developed countries. Nowadays also a large number of people use biomass like fuel wood, animal dung, etc., you know, for cooking and heating. However, more advanced and efficient technologies nowadays allow the extraction of biofuels from materials such as wood, crops and waste material. And biofuels may be derived from agricultural crops, including conventional food plants, or from special energy crops. Since the feedstock or raw material, we can say, since the raw material for these biofuels can be replenished readily, or since raw material for the biofuels is basically what, it's plant material, so it can be renewed, it can be replenished. Biofuels, you know, are considered as the renewable source of energy. Since these biofuels can be renewed, they can be replenished readily. That's why we call them as renewable source of energy. Unlike the fossil fuels like coal, petroleum and natural gas, you know, these fossil fuels are non-renewable source of energy. So the crops that are used to make biofuels are generally high in sugar. For example, sugar cane, sugar beet and sweet sorghum, or crops that are high in starch such as maize and tapioca, or oils such as soya bean, rapeseed, coconut, sunflower, etc. So all these crops are used, you know, to produce biofuels. Biofuels are generally classified into three main categories. We have first generation biofuels. First generation biofuels are produced directly from the food crops, those crops that are used as food. So the first generation biofuels are made from sugar, starch, vegetable oil or animal fat using conventional technology. Some common first generation biofuels include bioalcohols, biodiesel, vegetable oil, bioethers, biogas, etc. Then we have second generation biofuels. These biofuels are produced from non-food crops, those crops that are not used as food. For example, cellulosic biofuel, cellulose, so those fuels that are derived from the cellulose. Cellulose means leaves, stem and other fibrous parts of a plant. And waste biomass, like waste from, you know, wheat, corn, etc. Wheat, corn and wood. So the waste of these plants, you know, can be used to produce fuel. That's called as second generation biofuel. Like examples include advanced biofuels like biohydrogen and biomethanol. Then we have third generation biofuels. Third generation biofuels are produced from microorganisms like algae. These biofuels, you know, have certain advantages since they are the renewable source of energy. I already told you, as the raw material is basically plant material or animal waste. So raw material can be renewed, replenished easily, readily. So these biofuels are renewable source of energy, less carbon emission. When these biofuels are burned, they release as much carbon as they absorbed during their growth. Although some carbon dioxide will be released during the production of these plants, for example, some machines like tractors would be used, so slight carbon emissions would be there, but it is less as compared to fossil fuels. These biofuels will reduce our dependence on or reliance on fossil fuels. And the cost that is involved in the production of these, biofuels, or the cost of these biofuels, is low. Since ethanol is cheaper than petrol, and if ethanol is mixed successfully with the petrol, so the overall cost could be low. So the blending of these two, could be cheaper. So disadvantage of biofuels is that producing obtaining biofuel, it needs large areas of land, and that land can be used to grow food. So that is one of the disadvantage here. And this production of this biofuels needs a lot of labor. Bioethanol cannot be used in cars without modifying the engine. So that is one of the disadvantage, since if bioethanol, that which is a biofuel, if it is to be used in cars, so the car engine needs to be modified or needs to be changed. So that is one of the disadvantage. Well, this is all about the biofuels. Thank you. Have a nice day.